Staying in Tasmania, and the last known thylacine or Tasmanian tiger died in captivity in 1936. But the idea that thylacines lived in the wild has never quite gone away. Now a film about a man who's hunting down the last Tasmanian tiger has had its Australian premiere. The plot of The Hunter isn't too far removed from reality. The true believers who say that the tiger is still out there. Felicity Ogilvie reports from Hobart.
The thylacine may be officially declared extinct, but people keep seeing the Tasmanian tiger. Wildlife biologist Nick Mooney has been investigating the sighting since the early 80s.
The last exciting one was about 18 months ago up near Lake Rowellen. That was a couple of guys hunting who said a thylacine ran across in front of their vehicle in the spotlight, and they were poaching at the time, so illegally hunting. So obviously something happened to excite them enough to come forward and say what they'd seen.
Proving that the animal is still alive is the lifelong passion of Cole Bailey. He's been searching for 44 years and has written books about the Tasmanian tiger. He says that after years of smelling and hearing the animal, he finally saw one in southwest Tasmania in 1995.
I got a tip off from an old bushman that there may be tigers in there, and it took me quite a few years to actually achieve my aim, but eventually it paid off. But no, I didn't get a photo.
One of the most famous and credible sightings of a tiger was made by Hans Narding back in 1982. Mr. Narding was in Tasmania's far northwest, near the Tarkine, doing a bird survey for the Park Service. He says he was camping in his car for the night when he turned on a spotlight to check what animals were out and about.
The beam of my spotlight came to rest on a tiger standing just in front of my vehicle. And he was so close that I had a very good look at him. Of course, immediately I thought it would be nice if I could take a photo of it, but I was in an awkward position inside my sleeping bag. It was pouring with rain. I had my arm out of the window holding the spotlight, and I didn't dare move it in case the animal would just disappear.
Mr. Narding is sure that he saw a Tasmanian tiger, but he thinks it was probably the last one.
For an animal for that size to survive, you need a gene pool of at least 100 or a couple of hundred specimens, and that's unlikely to go unnoticed for any length of time. So no, I don't think there are any left.
The state government took Mr. Narding's sighting so seriously that it sent wildlife biologist Nick Mooney to the area to search for the tiger. Mr. Mooney's been investigating reports about the tiger ever since.
I've sort of dealt with hundreds of reports, and not all are sighting reports. Some are people hearing something strange or finding odd footprints or having a feeling, everything you could imagine, from truly nutty professors to some extremely credible people who it's almost impossible to imagine they'd have any motivation to make up the story. Essentially, I wasn't there, so I don't know.
What's your opinion? Do you think that the animal is still alive?
No, I think it's likely gone some decades ago, but it is possible it's there.
Mr. Mooney says the most credible sightings of Tasmanian tigers actually come from Victoria. And there's a theory to back up that story. The true believers in Victoria think that some Tasmanians smuggled tigers out of the state when they realised the animal was headed for extinction. So the elusive Tasmanian tiger may still be out there, but not necessarily in Tasmania.
Felicity Ogilvie reporting.